Make sure you guys check out www.procivic.com for all your 9th gen and Civic needs. And also make sure you guys check out www.blinkingbrakelights.com for blinking brake light tail bulbs, which can help you better be seen and safe out in traffic. Use the code GOTTA10 at checkout for 10% off. What's going on, guys? This is your boy Gata Maliga, and today we're going to be installing the Buddy Club short shift that I got a couple days ago onto my 2015 Honda Civic Si. And this installation process applies to every single 9th gen Civic. That includes 2012, 13, and 14. So this applies to all the models across the board. If you're planning to pick yourself up a Buddy Club short shifter, head over to procivic.com and pick one up yourself, and then install it on your vehicle and use this install video as a guide to how to install your short shifter. Now, just to let you guys know it off the bat, ProCivic already has a tutorial video on how to install the Buddy Club short shifter, but I felt like this installation video is gonna go a little bit more in depth than Rudy did in his install video. But if you still want to check it out as a reference, the link will be down in the description below. You can check his video out for his installation process. Now, let's get this installation process going and let's get this short shifter on the car. So the first process into getting this short shifter installed is to take off this shift boot right here. Okay, so the shift boot actually is clipped on right here. You can see these little clips. You take a flathead, you put it in there, you undo the clips, and you push down on this little, on the boot, and the boot should slide right on down. So let's go ahead and do that. There we go. Your next step will be taking a 14 millimeter wrench, sliding it in here, and then untwisting the shift knob to take it off. And out comes the shift knob. And also you're gonna take off this little locking portion right here as well. You're gonna take that off. It just twists right on off. And now comes the locking portion of the shift knob assembly. So now that we have this taken care of, it's time to undo this plastic trim piece right here where the shift knob assembly sits under, which is pretty easy. You just kind of take a flathead with some tape, shove it in here, and kind of pry it off. Now what you want to do is unclip these connections right here. It's pretty easy. That's one. That's two. Okay, so I'm gonna leave the cigarette lighter one on because it's that one's a little bit too complicated to take off. So now we have to take off this plastic portion of the interior in order to move on to the next step. It's pretty easy. All you gotta do is lift up on the armrest, take a flathead, put it in here, and start unprying it. Toss this to the side. So now we have access to all the bolts and pieces that we need to remove in order to remove the stock shifter assembly. So what I'm gonna do first is put it in fifth gear. Should be easy, right there, that's fifth. I hope, hold on, that's first, third, fifth, sweet. All right, so it's in fifth gear, and as you can see, the cotter pin assembly that Rudy spoke of right over there is easier to access when it's in fifth gear. So go ahead and put it in fifth gear, and then we're gonna have to take off these support bracket bolts out right here. They are 10 millimeter. There's one all the way down here, one up here, one here, and it should come right off. So let's take care of that. Alrighty, so I made a really long extension here. I put an extension on an extension to make it really long. That's what she said. That's really gonna help you take these bolts off. So take this first bolt off here.
Now what I'm gonna do with these bolts, I'm gonna toss them in the Buddy Club short shifter box so I have easy access to these bolts when I have to reinstall the short shifter. So let's go ahead and take care of the rest here. So this little next nut that's right down here, it's actually 8mm. So put that on my ratchet and let's take this one off. And out should come a support that looks like this. So take this support off and toss it in the box. Your next step will be to remove the 12mm bolts that are here. This portion I'm gonna record with my phone because it's easier to see. There's a 12mm bolt down there. So there's another one right down there. So these two need to come off as well. All right, so I figured out that I won't be able to take off the two down there until I remove the cotter pins and the shifter cables from the shifter assembly itself first. So let's take care of that, and then let's move on with the install.
And if you couldn't see the clip clearly, it's those little metal clips right there. So you need to unclip them to take this shifter cable off.
There you go. Put that to the side there, got that shifter cable off. And now let's get to the one on the side. There we go. And pull that little cable thing off. So this little thing I'm gonna toss over to the armrest here on the side. By the way, this washer is actually very, very important. So toss that to the side too. So now I'm going to twist this portion right here counterclockwise and try to unclip it from the support. But from the looks of things here, I might have to take off this metal support that's in the way, this little metal bracket. But I'm gonna hold my tongue for now. So yeah, it looks like I'm gonna have to take off this little metal support bracket because it's starting to cut up my hands. And I'm really not a big fan of that. So it's 2 8mm, I believe. Let me check. 2 8mm bolts on top and 2 10mm bolts on the bottom. So let me go ahead and take care of that real fast because I'm not in the mood to be cutting up my hands today.
This is where long session comes in here. So take care of the bolt in there. And this bolt that I showed you guys on the iPhone camera earlier, it's too on the very bottom here. And I'm gonna take this entire bracket off and then take care of the shifter afterwards.
Okay, and off it comes. So now this whole assembly here comes right off. You can see it here. It's all set in the box because we're not going to need it. And now let's try and remove this locking portion here of the cable. So it's two white clips here that I also need to remove. Let me show you guys on the iPhone camera here.
This is the awesome part about having an iPhone camera. You take these like little white clips here and you unclip them. Can see that here. Okay, that's one side done. There we go. The white clip is off, or it should be. This wiring harness is really irritating me and getting in the way. But all right, so that white clip is off. So I didn't manage to record this portion, I apologize, but you can see the spring-loaded turn thing. You need to turn it and pull it out to the side to take it off of the shifter cable of the shifter assembly itself. And now we have easy access to that bolt that we need to remove in order to take off the assembly itself. So let's take that bolt out. It's a 12 millimeter. And then move on to the one on this side, which is a little bit more difficult. So what I'm actually going to do first, I'm going to take off this bolt here and see if taking this off makes it easier.
Okay. That bolt is off. Talk to that in the box as well. Now let's move on to the other shifter linkage cable thing, and then we can take the other shifter and put it in here.
Okay, so I managed to sort of twist it. Okay. So as you can see, it twists. So you got to twist it counterclockwise, and then push it off to the side. So I'm gonna try and take it off camera.
Let me see if I can take off this stupid little zip tie here. I'm gonna cut this just right off because I have no use for it. This thing's a piece anyways. There we go. And now I'm gonna take off the shifter cable assembly here. Woo! That took some elbow grease, but I managed to get the cable off of the assembly. And the assembly comes right out. So this one I'm gonna put in the back for now, and I'm gonna bring the Buddy Club short shifter and install that one back in. Install it as such. So it should sit right there. Now, what I gotta do with these shifter cables, which I'm going to show you in the other camera, is practically do the same thing. Turn them counterclockwise to open them up and then slide them back in. So I'm going to, hold on, I have to set up everything here. Bring this on the bottom end, on the bottom portion. Okay, so now I got to throw that stupid cable back into the bracket, which is going to be very difficult. And then bolt everything back up. So I'm gonna do my best to kind of show it over the cell phone, but highly doubt I'll be able to, but I'm gonna give it a shot.
All right, cool. So I'm gonna try my best to get this thing situated.
I'm gonna do my best by myself here to sort of figure this out. Okay, twisting it, twisting it, twisting it. Okay, untwist it all the way, and it should fall right into this bracket. There we go. Managed to slide that in and clip it. Cool. So that's one cable done. Now let's take care of the other one.
So I sort of have an idea as to what you need to do. So I'm gonna put the shifter back in here and untwist this as much as I possibly can with one hand. If I can slide that. So, there we go, I can slide that right in. And then just twist that tight. And you take the white clip and you snap it back on.
All right, so let's get some light in here, huh? All right, cool. So now what I'm gonna do is sort of wiggle. Okay, I need to put that washer and the cotter pin back in. I'm gonna go ahead and take care of that.
Your next step will be to take the shifter cable and slide it in this little plastic portion here. Slide it into this little plastic portion like that. You're gonna put the washer on there later, but for now, we're gonna focus on this right here. This is the little tricky SOB here that we need to take care of. All right, you know, I'm gonna do it with two hands off camera. And then we'll come back. So as you can clearly see here, you gotta push this up until it snaps. And you gotta make sure it's in place, because you do not want this cable to disengage at any moment while you're driving. So now that I got that done, I'm gonna put the washer and cotter pin back on this.
So you got to put the shifter cable in, the washer in. Then you take the cotter pin and you slide it in the little hole here. And then you just kind of push it down until it snaps. Boom. And that's all there is to it.
So now, in theory, we should be able to put it back in neutral. It is in neutral, which makes my life so much easier. And now what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna throw the bolts in back there in the back portion first, and then these right here second, throw this support on, and then take care of everything else. So, I'm gonna grab my 12 millimeter here, switch it to tighten, grab the first bolt, and get to work. You know guys, I'll tell you something, man. This is a hell of a lot of work. Don't get me wrong, it looks easy, but you need to be very patient. Okay, that's all done. Get that tight. And then this one right here. Make sure that's tight. Make sure that's tight. Go back down on the other ones and make sure those are tight too. Sweet. So now what we gotta do is put that support bracket back on, which shouldn't be too difficult. This big hunk of meat. So that goes on under it like so. So let me go ahead and bolt these up. Let's take care of the bottom portion first.
So as you can see, there's a screw down there, I mean a nut down there, and a nut over there. So you gotta make sure you tighten that one down, this one down. You take your 8 millimeter, tighten this one, and this one, and that support is on.
Okay. I don't wanna go too far on that one because that one actually can be stripped. So, one pain in the butt bolt down there. A hold of it, all right, cool. I thought I didn't have a hold of it first. It's always good to hand tighten your bolts first so you don't strip them here like this and like so. There we go. And that's the support bracket on. So now our next step is to take care of this support bracket, which goes down here. Okay. That's pretty much tight. Switch back to my 8 millimeter. There we go. All right, so now all we have to do is put the interior assembly back on. And then once we get the interior assembly back on, we can start putting the shift boot and shift knob back on, and then we'll take it out for a rip. So put this portion in first, like so. Should snap right in place. So now what we have to do, this is the USB port. So that one goes in here. Just do my port there. We can now sort of assemble this piece back together. Oh my god, my wires are everywhere, aren't they? Whatever. There we go. Alright, cool. So, put that on as such. Make sure everything's lined up here. Sweet. This locking collar here, and we screw it back in to where it needs to be. And screw that back on as such. Now the shift knob's a little bit crooked, so in order to fix that, you kind of need to play with the locking portion here. There we go. And that is fully adjusted. Slap the shift knob portion back in, and there we have it. It is now installed. It's about maybe 15-25% shorter than stock. What I'm gonna do is, in the next few videos here, I'm going to be reviewing this short shifter, so stay tuned for that. I'm gonna take it out for a rip right now, so I can give you guys my thoughts. And this has been your boy, Guy Maliga. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this install video. I know it was a little bit weird because of the camera positioning and everything, but hopefully that sort of explains any doubts you may have about the short shifter install. This works for an Acuity short shifter as well, which, by the way, I will be getting an Acuity shifter, but I wanted to sort of try out the Buddy Club first before trying out anything else. So anyways, this has been your boy, Guy Maliga. You can follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. That's down in the description below. This has been your boy, Guy Maliga, and I'm out. Peace.